Welcome to KidStep. Hey friends, I'm Miss Caitlin, and I'm so excited you're joining me today. We're gonna jump into God's Word together. Do you know why we need to read our Bibles? Well, God has given us His Word so that we can know Him and understand how we are made to worship Him. Long ago, God spoke to the prophets and gave them important messages to give to the people. So when we read the Bible, we're learning about the messages that the prophets spoke. In today's story, we're going to hear a message that the prophet Isaiah told the people. So let's see if we can recite the big picture question and answer together. It's on the screen if you need some help. What is idolatry? Idolatry is a sin of the heart in which we love and value something else above God. Idolatry hurts us because idols, they lead us away from God. And sometimes we look to other things to do what only God can do. But God gave us His Word and Jesus to remind us that He is the one true God. Just as a boat is made to move through the water, our hearts are made for God. God deserves all of our love and our worship. So let's say the big picture question and answer together again. What is idolatry? Idolatry is a sin of the heart in which we love and value something else above God. God sent prophets to the people of Israel to tell them to stop worshiping idols. The kings, Jeroboam and Ahab, led the people to worship false gods. But God was merciful and sent prophets to remind the people that He is the one true God. And then Elijah and Elisha performed miracles to point people to God. The miracles also showed the people that God is the one true God. Today, we're going to learn that God used the prophet Isaiah to tell the people to stop worshiping idols and return to worshiping the one true God. So if you have your Bible, open it up to Isaiah chapter 44. Isaiah was a prophet who lived long ago, more than 700 years before Jesus was born, in the time when Israel was ruled by kings. God had chosen Isaiah to take God's message to His people, the Israelites. The name Isaiah means the Lord saves. God used Isaiah to tell His people a very important message. And this was the word of the Lord, the message from God that Isaiah the prophet spoke to the descendants of Jacob. Isaiah said, "Listen, Israel, this is what the Lord, the King of Israel, says. I am the first and the last, the one true God. Can anyone else say what will happen in the future? No, do not be afraid or surprised. There is no other God but me. Everyone who makes idols wastes their time. They look to their idols for help, but no help comes. Their idols are worthless, and those people will be ashamed by their idolatry. The iron worker labors over coals, shaping an idol with hammers, and as he works, he gets hungry, thirsty, and tired. The woodworker measures and chisels wood. He uses a compass to make an idol in a form he thinks up of his own. People look to their idols for salvation, but iron and wood cannot save. Remember these things, people of Israel. I will never forget about you. Do not worship created things. I, your creator, have swept away your sins. Return to me, for I have redeemed you. Rejoice, this is what I have done for you. Sing and shout, for the Lord, the one true God, is glorified through you." Let's watch our Bible video to review that story together.
Isaiah was a prophet who lived long ago, more than 700 years before Jesus was born, in the time when Israel was ruled by kings. God had chosen Isaiah to take God's message to His people, the Israelites. The name Isaiah means "the Lord saves." God used Isaiah to tell His people a very important message.
This was the word of the Lord, the message from God that Isaiah the prophet spoke to the descendants of Jacob. Isaiah said, "Listen, Israel, this is what the Lord, the King of Israel, says. I am the first and the last, the one true God. Can anyone else say what will happen in the future? No. Do not be surprised or afraid. I told you this long ago. There is no God but me.
Everyone who makes idols wastes their time. They look to their idols for help, but no help comes. Their idols are worthless. Those people will be ashamed of their idolatry.
The iron worker labors over coals, shaping an idol with hammers. As he works, he gets hungry, thirsty, and tired. The woodworker measures and chisels wood. He uses a compass to make an idol in a form he thinks up on his own. People look to idols for salvation, but iron and wood cannot save.
Remember these things, people of Israel. I will never forget about you. Do not worship created things. I, your creator, have swept away your sins. Return to me, for I have redeemed you. Rejoice. This is what I have done for you. Sing and shout, for the Lord, the one true God, is glorified through you.
God alone is worthy of our worship. He sent his son, Jesus, to die on the cross and save us from our sins. We can turn from our idolatry and evil ways to rejoice in the God who saves.
Okay, time to review. Isaiah was another prophet that God sent to share God's word with the people of Israel. God told Isaiah to tell the people that their idols were worthless. The people looked to the idols for help, but the idols could not help them. So who did Isaiah say could save them? Only God could help them and save them from their sins. Isaiah told the people to turn away from the idols and to worship God alone. What did Isaiah tell the people to do because God was able to save them from their sin? Yeah, Isaiah told them to rejoice. Even though the people of Israel had turned away from God and had worshiped idols, God had made a way for their sins to be forgiven. And God also wants us to turn away from idols and to worship only him. God knows that an idol cannot save us, and God proved that he loves us and can save us when he sent Jesus to die on the cross for our sins. Only God deserves to be worshiped with all of our heart, mind, soul, and strength. God alone is worthy of our worship. He sent his son Jesus to die on the cross and to save us from our sins, so we can turn from our idolatry and our evil ways to rejoice in that the Lord saves. Do you want to check out this week's Questions from Kids video? Okay, let's check it out.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Kevin. It's time for Questions from Kids. Cyrus from Portland, Oregon asks,
I don't like to sing. Are there other ways to worship God?
Oh, I really like this question because I don't sing very well at all. You should hear me and my family trying to sing. Now, none of us can carry a tune very well. However, singing is a command, and that's why we try to worship God in singing together. Singing is not an option. We see that the Lord commands us to sing. Like in Psalms 96, he says repeatedly, sing a song unto the Lord, sing worship songs to him. We see in other Psalms that we should make a loud shout of praise unto the Lord, singing worship and praise unto him, because he is worthy of our worship and worthy of our praise. We also see tucked right in Zephaniah chapter 3, verse 17, that the Lord God himself actually sings songs over us. So we know that in the scripture that singing is a significant part of worship. Now, so that you know you must sing, I also want to tell you some other ways that you can worship God. You can worship God by serving others, both in your school and in your community and in your local church. And I would encourage you to talk with your group leaders and parents about ways to come together to serve others together as a family. You can also worship God by giving, by giving the tithes or giving an offering. You can also worship God at school by helping your friends and helping your classmates and helping people that may be lonely. You can also worship God by obeying your teachers and your parents and all of God's commands. All those are ways that we can worship God. I would encourage you to make a list of those ways and to worship God, and even remember to worship God in singing. What are some things in your life that pull your attention away from worshiping God?
It's time for our missions moment. The beautiful music that you will hear in this video, as you see the scenes of the countryside and the people of Ghana, was written by a missionary kid named Trey Hahn. He helped his dad, William Hahn, create this video so people could learn more about Ghana. And let's check it out together. You know, Trey and his dad did a great job creating the music and videoing places in Ghana so that we could learn more about this beautiful country. And we can remember to pray for the people and the ministry happening in Ghana. Our key passage this session is Deuteronomy 6:4-5. So Let's read it together. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Love the Lord your God with all of your heart, with all of your soul, and with all your strength. Deuteronomy 6, 4 through 5. When we love other things more than God, we make those things into idols. And God commands us to love him first, that he alone is worthy of our worship. Because he first loved us by sending Jesus, we can love him with all of our heart, our soul, and our strength. So friends, I'm gonna pray for us, then you're welcome to stay to watch the key passage song if you'd like to practice your memory verse some more. I sure hope that you'll join me again next week as we continue learning and growing together. Let's pray. Dear God, thank you for showing us how to live through the Bible. Help us to follow you and to love you in all that we do. Thank you for loving us first. Amen.